The views are spectacular, especially when you consider what came first. The permit area is more than 8,000 acres, and 57% of it was previously mined, left behind with little or no reclamation. But with valuable coal available, the company made a choice. It took responsibility for the abandoned mine and the reclamation that came with it. It's called the Barren Fork Pit, named because the ground was so compacted it couldn't support reforestation. When the company completed mining in 2015, it started working on more than 100 acres of land, with an emphasis on wildlife habitat.
We've created a few wetlands where we could. Brush piles, the brush, instead of burying it, we put that up, piled it up for rabbit cover, for any kind of wildlife cover, nesting sites. Just, it's going to be planted back in trees anyway, so it's wildlife, why not put the brush piles up there?
In addition to building sanctuary for the wildlife, the company also spent time clearing out 8 streams and decompacting soil with low-pressure equipment. It placed more than 48 inches of recovered topsoil to help generate new tree growth and concentrated on providing water.
We developed some rock structures for our core ditches to drop those down, which have pools at the bottom of them. Generally, most of them enhances a place for wildlife to get water available, frogs, whatever, live in there. Plus it slows down our erosion considerably. We had some low areas that we created to hold some more water back, and it just enhanced it, brought in some more ducks. Geese use it a lot. It's pretty nice back here.
The company also eliminated more than a mile of dangerous highwall and then mechanically planted more than 250,000 saplings, including plum, oak, walnut, pecan, and persimmon trees. With enhanced areas for nesting and protection and better water supplies, all kinds of wildlife have returned to Barren Fork, including raptors, turkeys, and waterborne life. And as a result, Barren Fork is home to a national award.